Welcome back to Face the TV, guys. We are live once again. We have H2k and Kick. No more nuke, no more NIP. We are on Inferno this time, and this should be a much closer match than we've seen from the previous three, of course. And that's a great way to end the night, I think. Let's see how these teams fare against one another. Any thoughts, any predictions going into this as they start the ninth round, Thorin?
I would probably predict that H2K wins, but maybe narrowly, so let's say like 16-12.
16-12? All right. It's good to get some Inferno in. How are you finding Inferno at the moment in CSGO?
I think it's a good map. I think it's one of the best, actually. I like maps that, in general, okay, they can have a bias overall, but there has to be more wiggle room, I think, to be able to win T rounds. And the problem that CSGO has is that, okay, it has the really CT-sided maps, but then most of the other maps are just not as CT-sided. Okay, Dust 2 can obviously be T-sided, but it's not the same as in 1.6 where you had more of a balance over which the maps favored. It feels like a lot of the time it's a CT game.
All right, so we do go into pistol round now, and we'll see how this turns out. We have Kick on the terrorist side, H2K on the CT side. So, looks like Ruben is actually just going for a bit of peek action here with a knife out. It does spot one player, just looking for that information. And it was just Fox who was pushing up there, the lone man. Looks like they're making a concentrated effort up mid. Can H2K defend this? Or just pushing down Arch right there. And Montreus is going straight in for some quick burst fire there as Fox goes around short, catches Hoyland in pit in the side of the head, and they've taken control of the site, got the bomb down, looking for the setup. Very well executed this push by Kick so far. Just quickly in there with the bomb down. Now it's up to the counter-terrorist side for this retake. Can Kick, or H2K do it rather? We've got Polly moving in from short. Got Skirk and Mark Lord edging their way in, synchronizing here, trying to cover each other. And Mark with two quick frags, Emotion with a trade, but Polly's got his back. And here goes Polly with another frag, but the bomb is ticking so fast. Can he do this? No time, surely. And he's not going to do it. The bomb will explode. Very well executed from H2K. So quickly in there, and they didn't really lose any men on the push.
They would have actually won the round outright, except that Polly like headshot a bunch of them in like instant reaction shots, so they couldn't have known that would happen. I think in general, I would expect in this game that H2K will be ever so slightly more skilled just on a couple of their guys. Like we saw from the NIP game, the Polly guy was pretty good. From what I remember from the other NIP game, Emotion and Fox were probably the best players I think we saw for them.
Yep.
So I'm just going to look for like how the stars match up in this game.
All right. It looks like Rubino going to do a quick pop flash there, looking for the frag to help his teammate out, but they cannot do it. The SMGs pretty strong in this anti-eco round for Kick. And they've only got two players left to contend with. Make it one as Hoyland is the last left stand. He's going to get caught in the back. And there you go. It's going to be second round for H2K. As we go into a complete eco now for the counter-terrorist side, the Portuguese Kick Gaming. Aha, I keep getting confused by the switch names. I am a victim. I am the victim here. Either way, Kick now making their way up through towards Banana with Fox. He seems to be the man who looks to edge for some map control over on the Banana, trying to get some information or even a frag if they get aggressive there. But Hoyland going to test the apartments there into second mid. Doesn't find anything. Great kill from Mac there. Dropping the bomb gives the information at least to Kick, but to H2K rather. But Kick going to be holding mid strong with those SMGs. Great little nade there from Muteris. You see that shooting the gun away there. Kick just holding their ground. They don't want to get caught by the pistols. They have the time to waste, and that's what they're doing in case their opponents get a bit greedy with those pistols, but here, the time to move is now. In come the flashes. There's Skirk, though, from H2k in the library. He's going to pop out. Can he get the headshots he needs with that weapon? He cannot find them, but he gets the information. Oh, Rubino's going to take down Killdreams, and that's a really good frag there. Polly's going to try to defend as well, but three players left for kick. They managed to take the round. Got a little bit chaotic, but it's 3-0 now, and we move it into the first buy round for H2k. And very interested to see the kind of style that we'll see from the terrorist side.
They're sending three towards the banana, so it looks like they will push it up.
Looks like they're just holding for now. Slowly edging their way down, but the smoke is there.
And Hoyland is now looking like he wants to peek into the balcony area. He didn't at that point. But that is where everyone is coming, basically.
Here's our men. The pressure's on for the entry frag. Emotion at least gets the trade as they dive into the pit. They do have control of that spot, which is really important. Getting the nades out there, the smokes and the flashes, to buy that time to get the plant down and get some positions for the post-plant setup. Kick.
Now, Rubinia is going to try and flank from the house area. So actually, H2K is in a really good position to retake. They just need to time when Rubinia comes out of the balcony with when the others go in. So it should be around now that they go in.
Pressure on Rubino to get that frag. He does make it, and that allows H2K to rush in here. All guns blazing. Emotion, brilliant catch there. Onto Max Lord, and Rubino going to go for the save with that AK-47. So they do not manage to get that retake. And H2K go down another round.
I mean, personally, I would actually prefer if you do a strategy like that. Like, I like people who gamble on CT side and try and get early pushes so you get the info. If you send the three banana like that and you don't see anyone come up banana, I'd have rather Hoyland pushes into that balcony area to see inside there, does he see anyone? And if he sees someone, even if he dies then, your guys at B know to immediately go as fast as possible to rotate over, whereas a slower rotation like that, they did manage to get into a decent afterplant situation, but then at that point they couldn't catch anyone out. They just got killed one by one. So at least if you gambled the other way, then you could have actually defended the site before the bomb went down.
And it's like they're going to smoke off banana there. Kind of deny all that information from Rubino, which is really important. And RMN going to get a frag on the other side of the map towards apartments. And so things are a bit stressful now. The kick. H2K rather, losing Hoyland. And the kick are going to try to work on those apartments. And they do take down Polly as well. So they have control of the apartments. They're spreading up through mid, through short, and through long. And MacLord is there just with a pistol, trying to keep himself hidden for a quick frag. He does find one frag at least, but the odds are really against the rest of his team doing this. Rubino does have an AK-47, but he is sure as hell saving that. And Kick are going to go up another round. So do you really see a weakness in the defense here from H2K? They seem to be getting picked off a little bit early on the apartment side.
Yeah, I mean, their A coverage at the moment is really shaky. And then the problem is, since no one's going B, they have to make a decision now. Like, do we gamble? Like, usually what I would do is I'd just try doing 4A a bunch of times or have one guy right over near this arch, but ready to run as fast as possible to B because you have a really short time to get there. So you have to load up the sites like that. You don't want to just play the default positions. Because it's one of the key principles of Inferno.
Oh my God.
Has always been that it's the map where the CTs have to gamble if they want to actually, like, win out their side. Like, you have to... Now, a good team does it by correctly knowing when to gamble, but if you don't, then the second best option is just to gamble. Like, put four in the site this time, put three in the B site the other time, push up on an eco on the B banana. You have to take gambles like that if you want to win out, when it's even skills.
And the motion actually charging up banana, you'd expect a bit more aggressive play coming from the T's. It's usually Fox slowly pushing that. Emotion taken down instantly by Skirk. That's going to put a bit of a stop onto Kick. But they do have another player moving up slowly on banana. But they're just trying to work their way further and further into more and more position to gain more and more map control. As Mutaris might just go for a PK. Maybe gets a flash from a teammate there. Bit of a smoke to try to get himself out of the boiler room. And Polly's over at quad here. Just ready and waiting. And some flashes and smokes going down over at banana to try to confuse H2K. So they got 2-2s set up here. So they got their teammates trying to sandwich around from the long, but it just the position just gets completely held down. So now they're just alone at banana. They got to go, and go they do. Fox takes down one frag, gets a headshot onto Skirk, but gets his teammate nailed as well. Does he get the plant in time? There it is. He does. He even escapes, but 6 health against 3 players. This surely isn't happening, but they
no,
did.
There's no reason for H2K to lose this round now if they work together.
It's quite awesome, though, that they managed to actually get the bomb down despite the situation, put doing like a split 2-2 push on mid to try to distract a bit. And I think it's, you know, really on the strength of Fox just having like an amazing, you know, entry frag, even though he killed his teammate. I guess that's kind of bad, but did manage to get the plant down in the end at least, which did kind of save the round for them.
Well, the problem they had was, initially, I actually thought that I thought what they were going to do was the two men they had towards A did their smokes and flashes and stuff to distract and did hold the CTs there. But then one of them should have then immediately run back if they were going to go B, and then they could have had 3 go into B. Then you would have had a much better chance of getting the site down with bomb down with 2 people alive or 1 person on full health. So instead, I think they made a mistake by like overcommitting there to the fake.
And again, we're seeing Hoyland, the first man down for the CT defense. So that's one man less in the apartments area, and so now they know that they can, you know, previously we've seen them after getting that frag, they push apartments more because they know that HGK have to fall further and further back into the site, so their rotation time is even longer now. Looks like they might actually make a committed play onto banana here as soon as the smoke dissipates, but time will tell. Really defensive position, 2 in pit for the A defense from HGK, and this is it. Kickers have actually gone for a bit of a fake here. And in they go, straight in. 2 players in pit. This could work out well for HGK. And that is indeed a good result. Taking down 2 players on the defense. This is going really well so far. Can they get the third? Mark Lord will provide that. And now it's a 2-on-2. So big rotation time, but it is a 2-on-2. So there is a chance for them here. Oof. Emotion. He's been so great all day. And Rubino trying to make his way in the site. He is the lone man here. And Emotion going to pop his head off as well. Emotion has just been really just ripping players to shreds today. So it's, you know, kind of like you said previously, you know, it's kind of up to those big star players from each team, how they're going to match up. So far, it seems Emotion's doing really well on the T side for Kick Gaming. And we move 6-1 for the score. So Hoyland, like the rest of his team, just with a pistol.
And we've seen that H2K don't like to take gambles. They will have, like Holland will push the balcony and die, but other than that, in general, they're not willing to stack the sites differently or to push fully forwards. Even when they pushed into the banana on that opening round scenario, they only did it a little bit. And then when there was no one there, they didn't continue to push down. They just went back again. So they seem like more of a passive default style of team as CT.
And it doesn't seem either as if they're kind of trying to flash Hoyland in or anything like that. It feels like he's going by himself more or less as an individual play as opposed to a gamble with, you know, with the team. And again, they're in a 2-2 situation for the defense, and just with pistols, and they're really not going to accomplish much here. Hoyland might be able to get, he does get the headshot there and get Smurterus low, but we're just poorly left in the site. They're going to get the bomb down. This is going to be another round for Kick Gaming. So, looking into the next round, I would be pretty sad to see Hoyland going down really fast again.
This is actually a scenario where one of the things I always did for my teams when I was the in-game leader is if someone keeps dying like that, I either tell him, like, only play passive, and then another person in the site takes into account, like, okay, they might be able to shoot you with the first angle, so like be a little bit more like careful. Or one thing I've always loved from pro play on Inferno in 1.6 was to swap players to a different CT position. Because if you do that, then the enemy comes in thinking, okay, right, Holland's the weak spot. We pick him first. They come in there, but now I switched like Rubinho, one of my better players there, and he gets the kill immediately, and it's thrown their strategy off immediately at the first point, you know.
Right. And Kick is going to make their way through mid, finish that point in a moment.
See, the problem is where the H2K players pushed up to there looked good, okay, but then because they didn't go beyond that, it hasn't done anything for them. They've gone to the other side. Now, One of them has actually rotated over Hoyland, so he's going to be there in time, but everyone's dead by the time he gets there, pretty much. There's only one guy left in the site.
Great play from Fox getting the double there, and defending Library very well. And here goes Rumino, just going to charge straight in, and he's going to go down as well. So another very good rush, actually. That's a rush we saw earlier on from Kick, and they're executing that very, very well. They're very
H2k
quick with it.
H2k is very, very poor at reading where the enemy is and then knowing how to rotate. They only rotate after the fact. And when you do it that way, the terrorists know roughly the timing you're going to be there. You need to rotate where you're sort of guessing based on the first thing what that could mean. And that way you arrive 5 seconds before the terrorist thinks you can be there. So he's not set up. He doesn't have the bomb fully planted. He hasn't cleared one extra angle that would allow him to lock the sight off from you. And unfortunately for this, it's a pistol round. And so it's going to be a massive score here for Kick to open the game with.
Yeah. And actually, like, building on the point you're talking about before about swapping players, it's actually like a huge consideration to, like, as I think an in-game leader, I had like quite a few conversations about this, to kind of manage the emotions of your players as well. Like, if one guy's getting demolished on one spot, you start to lose confidence. So it's kind of like a self-fulfilling prophecy sometimes if you have a particularly emotional player who is not getting the frags that he needs as kind of like emotional reinforcements. He's going to start being less confident, and that can really hurt players, some players much more than others as well.
So the MacLord is going to peak mid with his AWP, it looks like here.
9-1 the score, so things are getting pretty grim here. Skurk does take down Emotion, which is definitely
now,
a great player.
Is aggressively pushing up the balcony area towards the steps.
Here he goes down Boiler. Polly's there. And that's a very good position for Polly, actually, considering how he's previously protected that spot, that angle. Mixing it up very well. And Ruben are going to try to see if he can spot anyone over at Banana. So things are slowed down as Kick try to
they should get all the information when they just saw one there.
They
should be around for H2K now.
And H2K all over them for once. Every time in this round, Kick tried to go for an option, they would quickly lose a player from a nice little bit of aggression. Then they had to, like, you know, reconsider their options, and then the same thing would happen. Just that seemed to happen repeatedly there, making it 9-2 now. So H2K at least getting some rounds on the board. And we're seeing an AWP from MarkLord. So interested to see how he's going to be using this. He was going to try to get the mid pick. That smoke wasn't too good, and it's going to allow him to take down Fox right at the start of the round. So, all because that smoke wasn't so good. Here goes Mutarist, though. On to Hoyland again. Hoyland getting nailed at that position. Definitely does seem like a vulnerable point. More excellent play coming in from Mutarist. And they move forwards now, taking control of house and short. They've got a massive play coming in with the plant onto the A bomb site. And there goes a good smoke from Mutarist to try to block off that angle, force the CTs closer. So that Kick get an advantage here from delaying as well as a better fighting situation. H2K getting demolished here on this post-plant setup. It's excellent. Very well played to Kick in that round. So 10-2 the score. And Kick, I mean, we were thinking this would be a closer match to close things out, but so far Kick are just having a really, really insane first half on the terrorist side. And they aren't switching up the position of Hoyland either. The Fox is just moving up mid a bit. Polly's been playing well from the short position, generally speaking. Looks like he tried to get a bit of information. They spotted a few players, but it's hard to know at the start of Inferno, like, if that really can mean much, spotting three players there around mid. As
Hoyland is a strange player. Like, when he saw that nade come in there, his trajectory of movement back meant he would have never escaped the distance unless he went forwards. So if he'd have actually gone forwards, he would have taken no damage, and he knows the enemy's to his right anyway. That's like an example of where doing the obvious play is exactly what the opponent expects you to do. And he's died so many times, he either has to play very, very passive and not die early in the round, or even more aggressive. And he's like just staying in that what he thinks is his comfort zone, which is where he's dying every time, basically.
And RMN actually sticking at boiler room. They're going to do the kind of flank for RMN whilst they push three men towards bananas. It's a brilliant play. We've seen it from a lot of top teams. And now they're just demolishing the defense in the side. But Skirk, can he do it? His pistol comes out, but he ran out of bullets. Fox will take that down. The smoke is there to cover him. But for how long will it remain? As Mark Lord pushes through, they need to get the plant down. It's a 2-on-2, and a lot of time has been wasted now. The bomb is not planted, and now Fox is the last man standing. This could be a round. It's down to Hoyland, and he does make the frag. 10-3 then. H2K at least getting around on the board. And to be fair, it was a really good play from Kick. You know, moving, they got that guy in boiler. Iron Man, who even managed to make some frags happen for his team. And still, H2K were able to actually win that on the retake, so very well played to them. But still, things looking very good for Kick, the Portuguese team at the moment. Only two more rounds left in this half, and looks like they're just feeling out right now what's going on. Trying to like push Banana, trying to remove the CTs from any forward positions, cut off their information as much as possible. And slowly they're taking control of apartments as well, moving in to apartments, maybe trying to catch Hoyland. They're very good at taking Hoyland down there. And here goes Fox. He's been stellar on the mid play as well. But so is Polly defending from short, but Fox is going to rush up towards Arch, smoke it up, and here they go. This mid play has been so successful, charging in right there. Fox with the spray, not going to connect much at all, and it's not going as well as it had previous times. A bit slow this time, and that's going to cost Fox his life. At least there's the trade. Skirk coming in with a brilliant flank. H2K are doing a much better job, moving it towards a 2v2 now. Bomb is down. All the information in the world for H2K. This is a simple matter now. And no chance of Muterus. So that was actually, we've seen this tactic, or this strategy rather, three times. I killed with the fire. Beautiful stuff. But now, are they going to go for the defuse? Yeah, they're not weak. That would be a really funny way to like not get the defuse if they're both really weak or something and they waste too much time. That'd be pretty funny to see, but we've seen that strategy three times now, and this was the only time that H2K were able to actually defeat it. And it was all about delaying, being able to delay in Arch when they were kind of making their way through Arch. Fox didn't get the kill very quickly, and that allowed the rotation just enough time from H2K. So last round of the first half, we're at 10-4. H2K badly, badly need this round. And we've seen a lot of kills going on to Hoyland very early on in the apartments. And we can see Kick are trying to take the apartments very quickly. Fox in a very interesting position, quite a risky forward position with that AWP. At looking for the shot, he's going to get it on quad, but he had no cover towards Arch, so he's gonna just get a one-for-one trade with that AWP, interestingly, and his teammates are just left over at Banana, slowly moving up mid now. H2K are really holding well onto this final round for the first half, but it's still a 2-on-4 with quite a bit of time left. We can see that Skirk is moving back towards Banana. They clearly don't know exactly what's happening at the moment, but key player sitting in a key position. Hoyland, he can make the difference in this round. It's all up to Hoyland getting this frag, and he does it. Might even get the second too. Hoyland looking to shut down the last round of this first half. Emotion, 12 health left. And he's a goner, and there it is. 10-5, first half is done. H2K only managing to clock in 5 rounds there. Were you expecting a result like this, Thorin, for the first half? Kick, very dominant.
No, I thought from based on the games I saw the teams before and when I've seen H2K play before, I thought H2K would be a little bit more skilled. And so as a result, I thought that they'd just kind of play like a fast rotation game and just try and take the enemies on at like their own pace, not like the enemy, not like the terrorists dictate when they attacked. But instead, Kick were, it was up to them. Anytime they wanted to attack A, full on, they could attack it. They'd always kill Hoyland. Then they'd be able to have, they'd have the time and the numbers to kill the other two terrorists, while the guys who were over at B took a long time to rotate. And so One of the main problems H2k had was because they never pushed all the way down the banana, they never had the risk of flanking behind Kick. So Kick could go at any speed they wanted into that site and never have to worry about any full-on flank, I think.
And Polly actually equalizing here, and they're going to go with that one strategy again. Polly is the flanker moving through CT spawn, or trying to. Maybe a bit too quick was Polly there. He needed to wait for his teammates to push up banana, as the CTs weren't necessarily rotating fully yet. But here they go, charging up banana. The sandbag position proves to be effective for Mutarisk, getting one frag, maybe needed another, but it's still a 2-on-3 in favor of Kick. So they've done a decent job. Can H2K get this bomb down? Charging through the site. Killdreams goes down at construction as Macklord tries to cover his teammate. He's going to get the bomb down. Emotion coming in, gets taken down as well. Just all on RMN. Make this happen with that 5 seconds, 5-7. This is going to be very difficult. There goes the flash. Going to try to take out Marklord here. And he cannot do it. Great round from Marklord there. H2K managing to do it on the pistol round. Very, very good stuff. That's absolutely what they needed.
And nothing particularly tactical, just people making the kills that they need to, and then that turns around in your favor. I actually thought that Kick would have been a bit more organized in terms of when they went in, but you could see they were hanging back waiting for the bomb to go down, and instead H2K decided they were going to clear the numbers before they tried to plan.
And we are back into the anti-eco situation again. So we're probably going to see, unless Kick get very aggressive, and that's some nice frags there. 5-7, so good. That is actually a huge result there. Two weapons being dropped at the base of Banana. And wow, Fox is going to get a frag with his 5-7 as well onto Polly. And it's just Hoyland and Rubino left, and there's guns all over the map that they can't necessarily easily protect. But Kick aren't risking being exposed going for those weapons. They're staying with each other, staying with their good setups on the defense here. H2K are going to have to be very, very smart if they want to win this one. They still have a lot of time to play with, and they're working towards Arch here. Here goes a peek. So they know where they are now. The B players can rotate and sandwich onto Rubino and onto Hoyland as they move into the A bomb site. Should be able to get this bomb down, but B players are arriving on the scene very soon as Rubino tries to lock down the apartments, trusting Hoyland to cover the back, and he does just that. And there you go, Rubino going to take the last player down. That was a close call.
Yeah, the key thing that won them that round was that the players from Kick couldn't get to the guns that they got because they took the fights at long range and got the kills. So they could never get over to the guns. And then because they didn't decide to like take a gamble and go for the gun or rotate back to A and then all be A, they couldn't either have numbers or guns to match them. And so in the end, it just ended up being a series of 2-on-2s. And the guys with the real weapons won their 2v2s.
And again, another eco coming in, of course. And it's a bit of a spray down over there. But still, they are making frags happen. And that's always nice. Gets a bit of money. And that's actually, I mean, a pretty important thing as well. If you're going to invest in the 5-7s and so on, you want to at least make a frag so that if you don't have enough to... Like, you can do a little bit of economic damage and get a bit of a return on the investment as well. And they do manage to do that at the very least. So they're in a full rifle mode right now. And 10-8 is the score. So H2K are climbing back in this. It's not looking quite as one-sided as we move into the second half off of that pistol round. Looks like they have control of apartments right now. Just slowly edging their way forwards. I've got Polly, who's about to take a peek with his teammate, Rubino, covering his back, and they get kind of denied, basically. Have to fall back a bit. Rubino losing a bit of health, good portion there. Fox, though, he can't be too confident to push back towards the middle position, as he cannot know how close they are now. So things slowed down again. But Hoyland out of boiler is going to be careful. He has no help here. It's going to be, again, that one flanker who is Hoyland, and the rest of his teammates are looking to push Banana, but they're slowly edging back. As Hoyland is able to give them information, they're liking the A push now, and here they go, rushing straight up. Fox, can he defend the arch effectively? Polly gets caught looking at the wrong angle, and Fox is going to hold down arch. He's going to look for the second frag. He gets it, whilst his teammates are trying to lock it down on the site, but Skirk will get the plant. Punching in those numbers. Here come the kick players ready for the retake. 3-on-2 right now. Good position for Skirk though. But they got one player coming from apartments. But Fox is on one health. This could be really tough right now. Here they go, all facing at once. Really good play from Kick as they move on to the site. Skirk, though, last man standing in the pit. Here comes Emotion, looking to do what he does best, and that's what he's going to do. Takes down Skirk, and they will get the defuse. Very good retake there from Kick.
And, yeah, I think actually what was strange about that round was I get the sense that H2K actually thought they made the Kick players rotate someone to B, because the way that attack was initially going, I think it was going to be Hoyland faking in A and just holding their CTs there and then trying to attack B. So I think the fact that they sort of changed their mind mid-round and just went for that A attack makes them think that the CTs only had two in A and that they could just do a full attack there and get in. And that didn't really work out, as we saw from the fact that they hadn't rotated at all, and so you were just attacking into the site that had three men.
And here they go, pushing into apartments again. Great little smoke going in. And Boiler compromised, but RMN is there to lock it down. So they failed to gain the ground there in apartments, which has been very, very crucial to both teams. But nonetheless, Kick are moving back for a rotation now. They've realized that it's likely to be B. They've got players who can be much quicker, still check on A, but be much quicker on the rotation. What are HGK going to decide? They still have time to actually fake this if they want to. Only four players, though. But this is going to be... I don't know how well this can go for them if they rush in all four together there. But looks like they're about to do that here. They come. First player gets taken down by Emotion. Spray down comes from Killdreams. Only gets one, though. But they're in great positions. It's a 3-on-1, all down to Marklord. Tossing in the flash there. Unsure exactly what to do. Looking for the bomb. Where is it? Does catch the bomb. Oh, he's going to go for the double back.
There's already a man rotated there, so he's actually going to meet him in mid now.
Here he goes. Got to pull out the rifle in time, but looks like... Oh! It's going to be a bit too slow, and he's going to get taken down. So, yeah. I mean, that four-man push there seemed like a bit of desperation. Like, they didn't know exactly what to do towards the end of that round. It's always very difficult when they lose the player around the mid and apartments, and they lose complete control of that area. And so I think they felt forced, a bit forced there to go for a banana play, perhaps. But 12-8, the score, so Kick, you know, retaking the situation, and Fox getting really low, needs to let his teammates help him out. Very good timing to escape there. Three CTs on short here. It's proving to be very successful in defending this pistol aggression as the bomb gets picked up again, but just two players left. And that's going to be it there, surely. But no, it's a 2-on-2 now, as I say
that. That was a really nice headshot from Skirk there, actually.
Yeah, it was brutal. And they have the bomb as well, so they're just charging towards...
And MacLeod has full health. He's the guy who can actually win them this round here, because Fox is very low health.
And here we go, MacLeod's going for it. Looking for that re-peek on the angle. Doesn't happen, though. It's going to be forced to the plant. He's just going to go for it, which is the right call. And here comes Fox. And
he heard the guy to his left, so he knew he had to headshot that guy, then turned to his left, but it didn't work out for him. He was killed instantly anyway.
Really interesting round by the merit of the options that were opened up by that amazing frag from Skirk with the pistol. But we move 13-8 now, and it's starting to get pretty bad for H2K. But at least for their sake, they're able to do a full buy with the AKs. And have you seen any potential vulnerable spots in the defense of Kick so far?
I think that the way they hold... I think like the left side of mid isn't so great at the moment, but we haven't really seen anything that could compromise that from H2K. Like their A attacks haven't really been particularly decisive. They've only kind of decided to go there at the last minute. And it looks like H2K still just want to try and get something out of going towards B.
Yeah. They have been really... They haven't made that many plays on mid, actually. That is really true. They aren't.
This is a key concept, actually. On Terrorist side of Inferno, it's one of the maps that you have to set up what you want to do in later rounds on earlier rounds. So if I want to go B for most of the game, that means at some point within the first four gun rounds as Terrorist, I have to get one successful plant inside of A, and then maybe another attempt at A where like I overrun it or I have a certain flashbang that tells them I'm going A, so that I can then set up that fake to allow me to go B later. Because unfortunately, if you try to just go B without any successful work done at A, then it's always going to be a very solid setup that's going to be hard to get into.
Certainly isn't. Hoyland coming out huge over at the A side of the site, the A site, and his players quickly fall in line over there to get the plant down. There's Polly with the bomb. And can we see another retake from Kick? It is a 3-on-3, but the post-plant, there is enough time for a post-plant setup here. And that is a very important kill there from Fox, taking down one of the two players around the pit area. And here he goes in for apartments.
The right position here. The problem is there's the man in the house, and he can do a lot of danger if he doesn't die.
And there you go. I mean, you got to say that the crucial kill and the crucial play for the retake was coming in from Fox there.
Because the thing is, as soon as that guy comes in, it always throws the guy in the pit off, because then he's worried about which to shoot at first, because he doesn't want to feel stupid and get shot in the side of the head by one of the two. And so if you're actually the guy housed there, you don't even have to push out and get the kill. You just have to kind of make your presence known, and then that's going to draw attention away from one of your teammates who can come in and kill him up close.
Yeah, it's like 14-8 now, so Kick are starting to really get very close now to that victory. H2k, they were looking really good for a while off the start of the second half, but now it's all falling to pieces. But Kick, Killjoon's going to make a frag onto Maclord, which really shuts down their aggression on Banana. And now their aggression on the house has been significantly weakened as well, as two players go down there. What do they even do at this point? There's two left, and they've got lots of time left in the round, but to be honest, with two players against five, they haven't really forced any rotations yet. There's not much to work with, but at least there is one frag there, but the trade goes down. Rubino.
So I made this comment earlier when we were doing the game where Kick was playing Nip, where I said that it's a mistake to always have the same people go to the same spot every single time, okay? Especially if you're going slowly, because then it gives information away. Well, Hoyland, as CT, always plays that house area, keeps going into it. And then as Terrorist, that's his role as well to play there. But since he's always there, and he's been dying all the time, he hasn't really been any use. Like, I don't understand why they just insist on going with what hasn't been working. Like, why does Hoyland always have to be in that house area over and over?
And here, Fox goes back, falling back there a little bit onto the closer towards Arch. And here they go, moving up towards mid, towards Fox's position. He gets instantly taken down there. RMN is put to the test, does manage to get at least one kill off that, but here comes Mutaris. He's the second guy, super important, great flashes, didn't get a frag though. There's the first frag, looking for another. They line up, but he can't do it. Rubino's going to take him down. They are just taking over the site. H2K have this plant in the bag. Great reaction from Skirk there to also finish off the player from Library, and it's all in the bag, unless Emotion comes out huge with a 1-on-3. He's got full health, he's looking for it, and we've seen this kind of play from him before, but Skirk is going to shut him down. And it is now 15-9 as H2K are holding on. So barely holding on right now. It's like, you know, they're holding, hang off the side of the building, and Kick are just like stamping on their fingers one by one. They're on their last legs, and there's no more mistakes to be made now from H2K. They've got to bring this back, force that overtime. If Kick win this, they are going to qualify for the playoffs, along with NIP from Group A, for the GSL Egamingbets Cup. So Kick are setting up for a lot of games on Friday. H2K with a full buy on the AKs, trying to expand into the apartments once again. They haven't lost a man yet. That's a great flash there. That is going to get a kill onto Fox for free. And they do spot the player on short there, who's boosted up. And here comes Hoyland. This could be really good timing. Hoyland got to make the frag. He does. Great headshot coming in onto RMN. And they've got the site secured now, more or less. So Hoyland's, you know, really making up for you know, let's say, not so great play on the CT side, or not such a great half on the CT side. And not much for Killdreams to do here, but save this. And H2K looks like they're going to hang on a moment longer, bringing it to 10-15.
Well, especially since the next round, they're going to be against like no guns, basically.
So H2K might be able to bring it to a... I mean, it's very possible from the T side, especially if they get a good feel on these aggressions. of the weak spots, and we're seeing more abuse here on mid, which is actually what you were talking about before, where you felt like when I asked you, like, you know, where do you feel Kick is vulnerable on the defense? They are getting some results coming in from pushes on mid. And, you know, Fox, that last round was completely decimated. That flash really caught him off guard. He got stuck in the corner. So the flash was perfect. And it would be interesting to see if H2k tried to deviate from these plays on mid, which has so far been keeping them in the game. And of course, as you pointed out rightly so, we have the pistols coming in from Kick, and they're doing, you know, the good old thing where they put three on B and then they don't spot anything, instantly rotate, going for the gamble. Here we go, gonna find Rumino here, ready for the angle into Library. Wow, what a headshot coming in from him, but there's more on Library. Very studious, our Kick. And very simple cleanup now. So it looks like H2K may have found a weak spot in Kick's defenses. And as you said, you know, we're not really seeing that much, you know, swapping of positioning from the players. So that weakness remains. Could be something for H2K to continue to exploit to bring this back some.
It's also basically the only terrorist attack that's worked for H2K. So at the moment, they're just going to keep doing it over and over. If you're Kick, that's where you want to see the response. Now, what is the response? Do you push aggressively down mid? Maybe you have someone go through the house quickly so that no one can be in that second house area where they come out of the door. You have to have some sort of a response that cuts off the base part of the tactic before they get into the execution part.
Let's see if Kicker, you know, have the presence of mind to do that. We have, of course, a three-man push coming in from Kick there on the B side. And now, you know, they've got their floater Fox rotating back towards CT Arch, the position he's usually taken up. And we've got most of the H2K players just hanging around Banana again. They've been really just pushing Banana so often.
Yeah, this is the time to push up like this on Banana like they were at the moment, because you want to keep information on, is there more than one person there? You can't afford there to be one who just holds you there while the others have gone back. And it looks like H2K, if I had to guess, I'd say at about 45 seconds, they're going to go to the A site now.
And Fox gets an easy kill onto Hoyland, who had no help there. And here comes the help, a little bit too late, but he gets just murdered by Fox's AWP. And they are forced now to push Banana. They have no choice. And Rubino is going to get cut down. Skirk is the last man standing. One versus five. He gets the first kill, looking for the second one. He will find that. The smoke is there to cover him. Got to swap out that weapon. And he has way too much work to do. That's going to be GG's all around. 16-11, Kick have qualified for the playoffs, which will take place on Friday. Of course, tomorrow we're doing the Group B play. And yeah, definitely we saw such a strong side there for Kick on CT. Any thoughts, Foreign? Any, you know, closing statements here for this match?
Not really. I think everyone saw everything they need to, and I'm pretty hungry, so we'll just leave it at that. See you tomorrow.
Definitely, and I just want to remind you guys as well, we're seeing so much more activity on the Face It website these days, so you should head on over to just jump on, try some pickup games, and play, you know, match games against all your friends. If you have no friends, like me, then you go and you press the solo queue button, and they made that especially for me. And otherwise, you know, play the Points Cups as well, I'm seeing loads of activity there. Of course, we have our qualifiers for the monthly championships as well that you got to jump in on, so check it out if you like it. If you like earning points, getting some, you know, new headsets and mice, and it's for you, go to the Face It website. So that's all for today's broadcast. Tomorrow, again, we have Group B coming up. If you're a fan of Astana Dragons, or Ex-Astana Dragons rather, you should be interested in following that as well. Of course, we have clan-mystik, HUDZG's team. It's got a really interesting name to pronounce. And we also have GamePub, the Serbians, who apparently, calling the Thorin, know Kung Fu. So see you tomorrow for all that action. We'll be back then.